Hi, welcome back. In the previous two lectures of insect systematics, we fairly understood the terminologies such as classification, taxonomy, phylogenetics, and systematics. With that clear picture, we were able to understand that the classification is in fact changing over the years. We were primarily depending on the morphological structures for classification, and over the years, we understood that phylogeny should be given the importance for classification so that the classification which we make is actually the natural. In fact, I recall the quote given by the Carlos Linnaeus that the classification is the foundation of any science. Similarly, insect classification in fact provides base for all the other subjects of entomology. In fact, in this lecture, I'll try to now introduce about the history and the present status of insect classification. In fact, I will try to give the updated version of classification, which is widely accepted and adopted. So let us discuss about the brief history of classification. In fact, Aristotle, who is considered as father of biological classification, in his publication, Historia Animalium, in fact, he was one among the early scientists who devised grouping or the classification of organisms. In his classification, he mentioned that animals may be characterized according to their way of living, their actions, their habits, and their bodily parts. So that means he was studying various kinds of organisms and he found that there is a variation, there is a diversity. He referred to such as groups like birds, fishes, whales, and insects. So in case of insects, he differentiated as mandibulate and ostellate. Okay, biting and chewing type of mouth parts and the piercing and sucking type of mouth parts, and also winged and wingless conditions. That means he gave the due importance to characters when he was actually classifying them. The terms such as Coleoptera and Diptera, the nomenclatures, are being used nowadays. Aristotle, which are being used till now. And after Aristotle, in fact, not a good contribution actually took place till very recent, up to almost 16th century. And the modern classification, in fact, began with the work of Carlos Linnaeus, who is a Swedish botanist, physician, and zoologist. And he, in fact, developed the binomial nomenclature and who is considered as father of taxonomy. In fact, he published a series of publications under the title Systema Naturae. The first edition of Systema Naturae was published in the year 1735. In 1766 to 1768, 12th edition was published, which was actually the last edition of Systema Naturae, which was published posthumously, in fact. Among the 12 publications, 10th edition, which was published in the year 1758, was the most important one. And 1st January 1758 is considered as starting point of zoological nomenclature. The reason being, in that publication, he consistently used binomial nomenclature, that is genus and species name. And hence, the 1st January 1758 is considered as the starting point of zoological nomenclature. In fact, in this 10th edition of Systema Naturae, he recognized 7 insect orders that included Coleoptera, Hemiptera, Lepidoptera, Neuroptera, Diptera, Hymenoptera, and Aptera. In fact, he used wing structure for classifying these insects. So that means he, based on the single character, that is wing structure, he classified the insects which he actually come across into 7 different orders. But in this 12th edition, he recognized 2 more orders, which included Orthoptera and Thysanoptera. The key feature of Linnaean taxonomy is that, in fact, he brought together unrelated forms. So what are those unrelated forms which he considered as under single group? Another thing is that he separated insects with common descent, which are supposed to be in a single group, which he separated into 2 different groups. For example, under Aptera, Linnaeus included not only all sorts of wingless insects, but even spiders, scorpions, terrestrial crustaceans, and myriapodons. See, what happened? Yes, these are actually the wingless organisms. He also included under the insects and under the group called, under the order called Aptera. Okay, that means the characters which he used, the classification which he used, in fact, is not natural. Okay, so now we fairly know that morphological similarity is not an indication of phylogenetic relationship. And another example is that Neuroptera included not only antlions and cyalids, but also termites and dragonflies. Okay, so the reason being, termites and dragonflies have got membranous type of wings. As a result of that, he included them under the Neuroptera. So now we know that termites and dragonflies undergo, they are exoterigotan insects, they are hemimetabolous insects, and Neuropterans are volametabolous insects. They are not come from a common ancestor. Okay, so that is one of the key features, or we can say drawbacks of Linnaean taxonomy. Similarly, you can see here, earwigs were placed under Coleoptera. Yes, these earwigs in fact have got hard elytron type of earwigs, which are actually short. He included them under the Coleoptera. Now you tell me whether Linnaean taxonomy is artificial or natural. So in fact, it is largely considered as artificial. But the work of Carlos Linnaeus is in fact gave a direction to the future further taxonomists, that the classification can be made so that it will be really helpful for further communication. For any other branches, classification is a very important science that we should attempt. And also, it was being told that Carlos Linnaeus himself used to tell that God created the organisms and Linnaeus organized. So that means God actually created so many different kinds of organisms, and Linnaeus in fact tried to organize all those organisms. Now we know that God did not create the organisms. It is actually the evolution which is creating the organisms, and the result of speciation we will find the wide varieties or diversities of insects at present. So, followed by the Carlos Linnaeus, his student J.C. Fabricius, who is actually the Danish zoologist, one of the greatest entomologists of 18th century, who actually published Philosophia Entomologica. And he primarily used mouthparts for classification. So Linnaeus used wing structure, whereas Fabricius used mouthparts for classification. So his classification included Eleutherata, which is presently called Coleoptera, Rhynchota, that means Hemiptera, Physeta, Hymenoptera, Antilata, Diptera, Glossata, Lepidoptera, Ulanata, Orthoptera, Cynisteta, Neuroptera, and Odonata. So these are the 8 orders which Fabricius recognized. But by the time people try to understand that the classification should not be based on the single character. So it was actually first recognized by the Giovanni Antonio Scopoli, who was the first to note that classification should be based on the whole structure of the insect and not just on the wings, the mouth parts, the antennae, or the habit of organism. Okay, so all the characters should be used for classification. So as a result of that, Breyer, 1885, in fact, used different characters for classification. In fact, he considered presence or absence of wings, types and structure of mouth parts, metamorphosis, number of wings and their origin, segments of thorax. So he used different characters for classification. In this classification, class Insecta consisted two subclasses, Aterygogena and Pterygogena. So these are the two subclasses and recognized different orders. So the 5 groups which he considered are Thysanura and Columbora, which he considered as a order. And then the Pterygogena consisted of 3 groups. Group 1 is called Menognatha, group 2 is called Menorhynchota, group 3 is called Metagnatha. Menognatha included exoterigota insects, or those insects which have got mandibulate type of mouth parts. Menorhynchota included hemipterous type of mouth parts, or they say piercing and sucking type of insects. And Metagnatha included endoterygotan insects, so insects with volometamorphosis. In fact, Lang proposed the terms Aterygota and Pterygota in place of Aterygogena and Pterygogena given by the Breyer. So thereafter, in fact, people started using Aterygota and Pterygota in place of Pterygogena and Pterygogena. And then comes the Jan Hirsch, who is an Austrian entomologist. He considered Columbora, Thysanura, and Diplura as 3 independent classes. Okay, so previously they were considered as harder, but analysts considered them, upgraded them into class 7, which we are using now. In fact, he studied the fossil insects with his main work called The Fossil Insects and the Phylogeny of Recent Forms. He became the actual founder of paleoentomology. So that means now fossil insects are also considered for understanding the phylogeny and the classification of insects. Okay, so paleoentomology has given a now very important base for further classification for the taxonomies. So thereafter, in fact, Richards and Davies, in their publication called IMS General Textbook of Entomology, widely recognized textbook, of course, Richards and Davies classified the class Insecta, which they considered under the phylum Arthropoda, into two subclasses, Aterygota and Pterygota. Aterygotans consisted of four orders, which included Thysanura, called silverfish, Columbola, springtails, Protura, Proturans, Diptura, Japizids. So these are the four Aterygotan insects which they considered. And subclass Pterygota consisted of two divisions, Exopterygota and Endopterygota. And Exopterygota consisted 15 orders, in fact. Epimeraptera, mayflies, Odonata, dragon and damselflies, Plecoptera, stoneflies, Grilloblatodea, rock travelers, Orthoptera, grasshoppers, Phasmida, stick insects, Dermoptera, earwigs, Embioptera, web spinners, Dictyoptera, cockroaches, Isoptera, termites, Zoroptera, zoropterans, Socoptera, book lice, Mallophaga, bird lice, Cypinculata, head louse, Hemiptera, bugs, Thysanoptera, thrips. So which were included under the division Exopterygota. And Endopterygota, which are nothing but the volometabolous insects, which consisted of Neuroptera, antlions, Mecoptera, scorpion flies, Lepidoptera, butterflies and moths, Trichoptera, caddis flies, Diptera, true flies, Cypinoptera, fleas, Hymenoptera, bees, wasps, ants, Coleoptera, beetles and weevils, Streptoptera, stylopids. So these are the 29 orders which were now recognized by the Richards and Davies. In fact, among these different orders, Epimeraptera and Odonata were considered as Paleopteran orders. So paleo means primitive, and these Epimeraptera and Odonata have no wing flexion mechanism. They do not have the ability to bend their wings above the abdomen at rest like this. They cannot place their wings above the abdomen at rest. Whereas the all other insect orders, in fact, have the ability to bend their wings above the abdomen at rest, and they are called Neopteran insects. So Paleoptera and Neopteran insects. In fact, they recognized different groups as well. And those insects which have got biting and chewing type of mouthparts are Orthopteroid group. Okay, so starting from Plecoptera to Zoroptera, they consider them as Orthopteroid orders. So which primarily included mandibulate type of insects with mouthparts. Whereas the remaining Exopterygota insects, Hemimetabolous insects, are called Hemipteroid orders, which have piercing and sucking type of mouthparts. Okay, Socoptera, Mallophaga, Cypinculata, Hemiptera, and Thysanoptera. Okay, so all others are actually Neopterans are also called Hemimetabolous, so volometabolous insects, which have got four stages in their life cycle. So this is the classification which was actually widely recognized and which consisted of 29 insect orders. Okay, so till recent period, maybe till last around 20-25 years, it was considered as widely accepted and followed classification, and being subjected to change nowadays after the entry of Willy Enig. In fact, Enig is called father of cladistics, who published phylogenetic systematics in German language. In fact, he's a German entomologist, Dipteran taxonomist. In fact, he gave a wonderful idea of bringing phylogenetics into classification so that natural classification can be achieved. Okay, as we know that phylogenetics is nothing but the study of evolutionary history. He argued that only shared derived characters could possibly give us the information about phylogeny, and classification would become monophyletic. Okay, if you use the shared derived characters, an ancestry will be there, if they are shared and they are derived over the years. Okay, all the descendants of that particular ancestor should be included in the classification, so that whatever the classification which we make is actually monophyletic. Okay, so based on his idea, he actually also gave a technique for constructing the cladogram based on the character wine. Okay, so let us see what is this monophyly which he was actually trying to tell. So monophyly is nothing but the classification which contains an ancestor and all the descendants. Say, for example, these are all the descendants which consists of common ancestor. So that particular group consists of all the descendants of a particular ancestor. So then only it should be considered as monophyletic. So it should be, it should not be paraphyletic or polyphyletic. Our classification should be monophyletic but not paraphyletic or polyphyletic. Paraphyletic means it contains an ancestor but not all the descendants. You can see here, it contains an ancestor but not all the descendants. One group is actually left out. So that classification is also wrong. Or polyphyletic, say for example, it is nothing but the grouping that does not include a common ancestor. You can see here, apes and mammals. Okay, they are from different ancestor. They are actually grouped into single more cluster, but living over the ancestor itself. That is also not a natural classification. So he actually gave a due importance to phylogeny, and he said that monophyly is actually provided a wonderful system of classification, which is actually the natural. So thereafter, actually, people started thinking about generating a phylogenetically based classification. As a result of that, in fact, the Richards and Davis classification, which was considered as IMS classification, which was widely accepted, was actually changed after that. So then comes actually the Neil P. Christensen, who revised, actually, in fact, he was influenced by the Inuit's work, and he published a review paper in a publication called The Insects of Australia. So in his chapter, The Phylogeny of Extant Hexapod, he gave a very different classification than the previously existed IMS classification. And thereafter, actually, it took over time, about 5 to 10 years for wide acceptance of taxonomists. And then, in fact, now we are actually in agreement with the Christensen classification, which is widely accepted and followed. So what is the Christensen classification, which he actually gave and accepted now? So in fact, the class Hexapoda, the class insecta which the Richards and Davis or the IMS classification gave, in fact, upgraded into superclass or epiclass, where it is actually called Hexapoda. Okay, so that means the insects are actually upgraded into superclass or epiclass called Hexapoda. This consisted of two unranked groups called Entognathus Hexapoda and Ectognathus Hexapoda. So Entognathus Hexapoda included two classes, class Elipura and class Diplura. So in fact, class Elipura consisted of two orders, order Protura, order Columbola, whereas the class Diplura consists only one order called Diplura. Whereas the Ectognathus Hexapoda are true insects, which were considered as class Insecta. And this class Insecta consists of two subclasses, subclass Archaeognatha and subclass Dicandylia. So this subclass Archaeognatha consists single order Archaeognatha, whereas subclass Dicandylia consists of two infraclasses, infraclass Thysanura, infraclass Pterygota. So this infraclass Thysanura consists of single order Thysanura, which is also called Zygantoma, whereas infraclass Pterygota consists of two division, Paleoptera and division Neoptera. So this Paleoptera consists of two orders, order Ephemeroptera and order Odonata. They are nothing but those insects which do not have the wing flexion mechanism. Whereas division Neoptera consists of number of subdivisions. In fact, they consist of three subdivisions. Okay, division Neoptera consists of three subdivisions, which includes Polyneoptera, Paraneoptera and Oligoneoptera. So subdivision Polyneoptera consists of Plecoptera, Blattodia, Isoptera, Mantodia, Grilloblattodia, Mantoplasmatodia, Dermoptera, Arthoptera, Plasmatodia, Embioptera, and Zooroptera. Whereas the Paraneoptera consists of Socoptera, Theroptera, Thysanoptera, and Hemiptera. And subdivision Oligoneoptera consists of four sections, which includes Neuropterida, Coleopterida, Hymenopterida, and Mecopterida. So section Neuropterida consists of three orders, Megaloptera, Repidioptera, and Neuroptera. Whereas section Coleoptera consists of Coleoptera and Strepsiptera, which indicates that Strepsipterans are close to Coleoptera phylogenetically. Whereas Hymenopterida consists of single order Hymenoptera. Whereas section Mecopterida consists of two superorder Antilaiophora and superorder Ampiespinoptera. Antilaiophora consists of Mecoptera, Siphonoptera and Diptera. Whereas Ampiespinoptera consists of Trichoptera and Leptoptera. So Leptopterans are actually order of recent no, evolved, no, insects. So now, whatever the classification which we studied, Christensen classification is widely accepted and followed. So let us see what are the major changes compared to the previously accepted, widely accepted Hughes classification and recently accepted Christensen classification. In fact, Christensen classification was given in the year 1991, but it took about more than 10 years or so for wide agreement of the taxonomists, and it took about 10 to 15 years for acceptance, and now it is being followed worldwide. Now is the most updated or the recent classification. In fact, if you see the Hughes classification, where they used A. terigota, which is not used in Christensen classification. In fact, now the orders such as Protura, Diplura, and Columbola were upgraded into independent classes under the class Illipura and Diplura. Archaeognatha was not included under the Hughes, which was actually got the rank of subclass, and then under the subclass order status as well with a similar name, Archaeognatha subclass and order Archaeognatha. In fact, all those 4 out of 5 Aterigotan insect orders, 4 have got monocondylic articulation, whereas the Zygentoma or Thysanura have got dicondylic articulation. So as a result of that, there is a very important thing which leads to separating that Aterigotan into different classes. That is another importance. Okay, so monocondylic and dicondylic articulation was actually considered, and subclass Terigota was ranked down as infraclass, okay, which was further consisted of 2 divisions, and then division Neoptera consists of 3 subdivisions, and the classification actually continues. So these are the major difference between the Hughes classification and Christensen's classification. Followed by the Christensen's classification, lot of changes took place. So one thing to be understood is that classification is dynamic. Okay, so thing is that once the taxonomist's understanding towards insects improves, the freedom is given to taxonomists so that he can consider 2 different orders into single order, or a particular order can be differentiated into 2 different orders. That is the freedom, in fact, the ICZN provides. As a result, the classification actually keeps on changing. Our understanding actually over the years improving. So important changes which took place in the recent time are, for example, Isoptera is no more considered as a separate order, which was actually merged under the order Blattodea, which were considered as phylogenetically, termites are phylogenetically considered as very close to cockroaches. As a result, Isoptera lost the status of order. Okay, so now Isoptera is not in the order status. Similarly, so you must be knowing that Manta Postmortodea was considered as the recently erected order. In fact, in the year 2002, Class, K-L-A-S-S, Class, is the scientist who actually came out with a new order called Manta Postmortodea. Till recent time, for about 6-7 years, people were using it as a separate order. But Erilla and Angel, in fact, merged this Manta Postmortodea with the previously existing order, Grillo Blattodea, and he considered the Manta Postmortodea and Grillo Blattodea as the suborder under the nomenclature, a order called Motoptera. Okay, so as a result, Manta Postmortodea and Grillo Blattodea also lost the order status. So that is the few changes. Similarly, in case of Malophagon Siphonculata, the Hughes actually considered them as the separate, Malophagon Siphonculata as the separate orders. But Christensen actually merged Malophaga and Siphonculata as Theroptera, and Malophaga and Siphonculata are considered as suborder now. So under Paraneoptera, under Hemiptera group, only 4 orders are recognized now. There is another changes took place. Similarly, Hughes actually considered Neuroptera as the single order. So within that Neuroptera, in fact, 3 orders were recognized. Okay. So in the previous case, some orders actually lost the order status. But here, 3 more orders are actually added within the order Neuroptera. Okay, so order Megaloptera, Rapidoptera, and Neuroptera got the order status under the section Neuropterida. So this is the another change actually which took place in the recent time. So now I will try to give an overall picture of position of insects starting from the kingdom Animalia. So kingdom Animalia consists of 2 groups, Invertebrata and Vertebrata. So under Invertebrata we have a more than 35 phylum are so. And the most important phylum, which consists of, you know, diversity of animals, one of the largest phylum is Arthropoda, which consists of number of subphylums: subphylum Trilobita, subphylum Chelicerata, Myriapoda, Crustacea. Within the subphylum Crustacea, Remipedia is very important one in the first class of fundamentals of entomology, the first lectures of fundamentals of entomology. I said that crustaceans are closely related to insects. Okay, till that period we were actually considering Myriapoda were actually close to insects. Now it is widely accepted that the crustaceans are close to insects. Okay, within that class Remipedia actually are close, are sister group of insects. And then subphylum Attilocerata. So these are the five subphylums recognized under the phylum Arthropoda. Under the subphylum Attilocerata, superclass or epiclass Hexapoda is recognized now. Okay, so within this superclass, epiclass, now Hexapoda, two unwrapped groups considered are Entognathus Hexapoda and Ectognathus Hexapoda. Okay, so that classification actually now continues. So even Christensen classification also changed in the recent time. As a result, now I would like to give the updated version of classification, leaving apart the section. Okay, section Megapterida, Neuropterida, Hemipterida, and Coleopterida and all is not considered now, at this juncture, as a separate rank. And also, super orders, which is rarely entomologists consider during their classification. As a result, I'll give an updated version of classification, which is now widely accepted and followed worldwide. So, superclass or epiclass Hexapoda consists of two unranked groups called Entognathus Hexapoda and Ectognathus Hexapoda. So, this Entognathus Hexapoda consists of two classes, class Helipura, class Diplura. Okay, so class Helipura consists of Protura and Colombola as orders. Diplura class consists of one order, Diplura. Okay, whereas Entognathus Hexapoda consists of class Insecta, they are true insects. So, if they are called true insects, these three orders are considered as non-insect and hexapoda. Remember, very important. So, class Insecta consists of two subclasses, subclass Archaeognatha, subclass Dicondylia. Subclass Dicondylia and subclass Archaeognatha. So, subclass Archaeognatha consists of one order, Archaeognatha. So, subclass Dicondylia consists of two infraclasses, infraclass Thysanura, infraclass Perigota. So, infraclass Thysanura consists of single order, Thysanura. Infraclass Perigota consists of two division, Paleoptera and Neoptera. So, Paleoptera consists of Epimeroptera and Odonata, means which do not, insects which do not have the winged flexion mechanism, whereas the Neopterans have got winged flexion mechanism. So, Neoptera consists of three subdivisions, Polyneoptera, Paraneoptera and Oligoneoptera. So, Polyneoptera consists of Plecoptera, Blattodea, Mantodea, Notoptera. Here you see, I am not recognizing the Isoptera, Notoptera, instead of Willow Blattodea and Mantoposmatodea, Notoptera is recognized. Dermoptera, Arthoptera, Posmatodea, Embioptera and Zoroptera. Whereas Paraneoptera, they are considered as hemipteroid insect orders. Socoptera, Theroptera. Here you can see, instead of Mallothega and Cypanthuleta, single order is recognized. Theroptera, Thysanoptera, Hemiptera. Okay, under the Oligoneoptera are the Volometabolous insects, Megaloptera, Rhipidioptera, Neuroptera, Coleoptera, Strepsiptera, Hymenoptera, Mecoptera, Siphonoptera, Diptera, Trichoptera, and Lepidoptera are recognized. So, in total, 31 orders are actually recognized under this updated classification. Okay, so in summary, of first three lectures of insect systematics. Okay, we studied the classification is the foundation for applied entomology. There is a wide diversity of insects that necessitates the classification. Systematics is helpful and a very effective means for communication. So, character similarity versus common ancestor. So, that means morphological similarity does not indicate the actual ancestry. ICZN and its guideline. Systema naturae and binomial nomenclature, procedure for identifying new species, type concept in nomenclature, synonyms and homonyms, traditional insect taxonomy, okay, maybe Linnaean taxonomy, IMS classification, as well as the recent updated version of NOC classification, which is widely adopted and being followed worldwide. Okay, so we went with now few questions. Why ASAPTRA has been merged with Blatodia? Probably the content which I presented will not give the answer for this, but if you really search for the answer, you will get a clear picture why classification is actually dynamic. Okay, so why classification keeps on changing? So thank you very much. If there are any questions, you can post below or you can email me as well. Thank you very much.